And now let me introduce another implementation that makes us really proud, because it's based here in Florence with the help of one of the most active private associations protecting the enormous Florentine heritage. And so I'm delighted to invite Mr. Lorenzo Manzani from the Amici dei Musei Fiorentini e dei Monumenti Association in Florence, Talking Tabernacoli, the first serial implementation of the Talking Places project in Florence. Mr. Lorenzo, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Good afternoon, nice to meet you here in Cenacolo, in Refectory, but also in streaming. Thanks to Carlotta and Caterina Del Bianco and Simone Giometti for the invitation. Thanks to Opera di Santa Croce for the hospitality in this wonderful place. Thanks to all boys and girls of the staff, Barbara Castellano, Chiarello Puliti and Partners, and congrats to all delegation for your very interesting works. I'm Lorenzo Manzani, I'm Florentine, I'm a member of Comitato per il Decoro ed il Restauro dei Tabernacoli, a special committee inside Amici dei Musei e dei Monumenti Fiorentini Association, who works about rose tabernacles, tabernacles along the streets of Florence, but also in the other municipality around Florence. How we come si fa per scorrere the next one? Ah, okay. Comitato Tabernacoli was born in 1991. We work about restoration and premise, first of all, but also decorum, lighting too. We study tabernacles, we organize public inaugurations, we put in contact each other, private owners of the tabernacles, with the restorers and the sponsors, something like this, many other activities. Comitato is composed by art historians, architects, simple volunteers, members of the Fine Arts Office of the Municipality of Florence, members of the Superintendents of the Opificio delle Pietre Dure, and also members of the Archdiocese of Florence. This is an example of our restoration. Here we are in Via Folco Portinari, Portinari Street, in front of our office. And you see on your left the situation before our restoration, and on your right the situation after the restoration. Observe the differences before and after the restoration. In the picture in the center before the restoration, and on the right and on the left, after Comitato Tabernacoli restoration. And you see in the picture in the center, there are strange objects. They are ex voto, to invoke God, Madonna, and Child for the end of the plague, or the pestilence, or the end of the illness. This is Madonna with the Child by Matteo Rosselli, 1619-1621. You see Madonna and the Child who is blessing with his hand. And it's very nice painting. Via Folco Portinari. Folco Portinari was Beatrice's father, Dante Alighieri, and his beloved Beatrice, you know, I suppose. Folco Portinari was a rich banker. At the end of his life, he decided to found a hospital, which named San Matteo Hospital. Then, century by century, the hospital grew up. It changed name in Santa Maria Nuova Hospital. And you see the marble white plaque up, the picture up. It says that in 1619, with Cosimo II de' Medici, Santa Maria Nuova Hospital grew up again, another time. And it was in that occasion that tabernacle was realized, from 1619. In the other picture, instead, down, on the Serena stone cornice, there is the crutch which is Santa Maria Nuova Hospital emblem, symbol. Another example, Via Boccaccio, the author of the Cameron, we are at Le Cure Zone, northeast of Florence. This sandstone tabernacle was commissioned by the Grand Duchess Cristina di Lorena, who was Ferdinando I de' Medici's wife. So, in the, on the sandstone, there is a Medici coat of arms, you see the picture down. This tabernacle is late 16th century, at the end of 16th century. Another example here is Via Sant'Agostino, near Holy Spirit Church and Convent, Santo Spirito, in Oltrarno zone. This tabernacle is in Via Sant'Agostino. It was commissioned by Augustinians of Holy Spirit Convent. In fact, on the painting of the tabernacle, there is the figure of Saint Augustine. This speech, Via Folco Portinari, Via Boccaccio, and Via Sant'Agostino, there is a strict relationship between tabernacles and the history of the city of Florence. Very strict relationship. Tabernacles were built on the corners of the streets, at the crossroads, at the road intersections, along pilgrimage routes, along the long streets. So they were the, landmarks, point of reference for the pilgrims, for the wayfarers. They were very important. Such as this tabernacle in Piazza San Felice, corner of Piazza Pitti, in Oltrarno zone, near Pitti Palace. And you see the yellow line is the tabernacle, an annunciation early 17th century by a Florentine school, maybe Agostino Ciampelli, maybe. And the green lines is the pilgrimage route to Rome, to Vatican. And the tabernacle was built at the corner of the street, at the crossroad, you see. One moment of Comitato Tabernacle inauguration in 2020 with Friends of Florence, an American no-profit association. You see the tabernacle up, people. Another moment of the inauguration. You see on your left, San Felice's parish priest is blessing the restored tabernacle. Another example, here we are in Piazza Santa Maria Novella. During the plagues, the pestilences, tabernacles were like open-air churches. In fact, during the plagues, it wasn't opportune to stay together inside the churches. So the religious ceremonies took place at road tabernacles, along the streets. There is a particular kind of typology of road tabernacles, named altar table tabernacles, tabernacoli a mensa d'altare in Italian. And during the pestilence, religious ceremony took place at this altar table tabernacles. You see in the picture down, altar table. This one moment of our inauguration, 2019, you see Basilica of Santa Maria Novella on the right, very beautiful. Other moments of our inauguration with the priest. Here we are in Via delle Brache, corner of Via de Neri, near Santa Croce, so not far from here. And you see the difference between before the restoration on your left and after our restoration on your right. We cleaned not only the tabernacle, but also all the wall of this historic palace. This is, you see, not only the tabernacle, but all this wall of the historic palace is a very beautiful palace between 14th centuries and 15th century. Tabernacles by night. in the evening, in the night, tabernacles illuminated are very suggestive, very amazing, here in Via delle Brache. In fact, we Comitato Tabernacoli collabs with Firenze Smart, which is the public society who works about public lighting, illumination in Florence, of the city of Florence. Here is in Via Panicale, near San Lorenzo, San Lawrence. You see on the right during the evening, with the lighting. Via Chiara, corner of Via Panicale, in front of Mercato Centrale, always in San Lorenzo area. This is a very important tabernacle, tabernacle of Santa Maria della Tromba in front of San Michele. This also is an altar table tabernacle with a lighting during the evening, in the night. Well, last June, Carlotta Del Bianco of Romualdo Del Bianco Foundation and Movimento Life Beyond Tourism Travel to Dialogue contact us asking to collab with them about Talking Places project, and we accept. So I wrote five itineraries of five parts of the city of Florence, which are also in that panel in the exhibition, and the last one is also in an itinerary in Oltrarno zone, San Frediano, Santo Spirito, San Felice. Then I gathered all our historic information from our Comitato Tabernacoli publication. I took lots of photos, pictures, and I passed all these things to Movimento Life Beyond the Tourism, and Movimento Life has digitized all these things. In September, there was a first presentation of Talking Tabernacles during the Festival of the Florentine Cultural Associations. These are some moments of the press conference in Palazzo Coppini. And I personally put a QR code for a smartphone, you see on the picture on your right. I put QR code on the Comitato Tabernacoli's plaque. Here in Via Taddea, corner of Via De Ginori, near Palazzo Medici Riccardi, near San Lorenzo Basilica. And in the picture on your right, I am putting a QR code on brass plaque. Comitato Tabernacoli, at the end of each restoration, put a brass plaque next to the tabernacle with the main historic information, name of the artist, religious subject, Madonna with the Child, Annunciation, Crucifixion, and so on. The date, name of the sponsor, the year of the restoration. And then now, with the Talking Places project, if you scan with your smartphone QR code, you have historic informations and three pictures for each tabernacle. This project is not only along the street, but also on a website, luoghiparlanti.com. You see in the picture down the map of Florence with 37 Tolkien tabernacles. In the picture up Via Taddea's tabernacle, and then historic information, and three pictures for each tabernacle. One moment of our past inauguration, 2019. This is a crucifixion by Giovanni Antonio Sugliani, early 16th century. This is Via Panicale in front of Sant'Ursula, always near San Lorenzo. On the left, I am put QR code, and on the right, I'm trying with my smartphone to scan QR code. This is Madonna of Carmel, because this tabernacle is on the wall of an ancient Carmelite convent. There is a strict relationship between tabernacles and the history of the city. Do you remember? Via Panicale 2, in Via Panicale there are two tabernacles. I am putting QR code, and I am trying with my smartphone to scan QR code. Madonna with the Child, copy from Sandro Botticelli. The original of Botticelli is in the Uffizi Gallery. You see down the brass plaque of Comitato Tabernacoli with QR code of Talking Places of Movimento Life Beyond Tourism. Via Chiara, corner of Via Panicale. This is Maholica of 18th century. We will see better. This tabernacle, there are two parts of this tabernacle, up and down. Down is an object to put money for the lamps, for the light who illuminated the tabernacle. An almoner. The part up with the maholica of 18th century. In the past there was this strange manufacture, this strange objects with we don't know exactly what it was. The part down before and after the restoration. Crowdfunding meeting, yeah. Before the restoration, we have a crowdfunding meeting with the citizens of San Lorenzo area quarter to sponsor the restoration. Inauguration. Oh, this is nice. we are in Via Faenza at Oratorio del Foligno, and here there are three different objects of three different periods. You see the white marble plaque of 1616, when Tabernacle was realized, and up the brass plaque of Comitato Tabernacoli, and on the brass plaque also QR code of Talking Places. So three different kind of objects together. Via De Canacci, also these three different. The marble plaque, it's a memory of a violent earthquake in 1895. Piazza Santa Maria Novella. This is one of the most important tabernacles in Florence, which named Tabernacle of the Five Lamps because of the five lamps, with QR code. Tabernacle of the Fonticine is the most important tabernacle in Florence, the biggest, Fonticine because of the water, you see down. This is a polychrome glaze terracotta by Giovanni Della Robbia with the QR code. Other pictures. Here near Holy Spirit, restoration this by Amici dei Musei. Via dell'Albero, Madonna of Lily. Lily, you see Madonna is holding a flower, a lily, which is also Florence emblem. A strict relationships with between Tabernacle and the history of Florence. Via Sant'Agostino, and I conclude, this is in San Frediano, Tabernacles or others artworks. This is not a tabernacle, but is a Cimadue crucifix. It was here in this refectory until 6 years ago. It was on that corner near the entrance. Now is in the sacristy of Basilica of Santa Croce. This artwork, this crucifix, it was seriously damaged by Arno River flood in 1966. It's a very important artwork. It's you see a very moving figure of Cristo Patience. It's a symbol for us Florentines. So I was saying that tabernacles or others artworks, it doesn't matter. It's the same. The importance is to take care of our cultural heritage, because it's our history. It's our identity. There is no future without our past. And it's very important to say this. There is no future without our own roots. And last one, our contacts. Contact us if you do want to sign us tabernacles who need restoration, or if you want to sponsor a restoration. And that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.